The volatility we've been experiencing over the last week or so foreshadows we can expect more of into the fourth quarter. And that volatility is not limited to the events going on in Hong Kong, but certainly that is a contributor to what's happening. Fears of the Fed exit, also redemptions from PIMCO, all exacerbating the problem. But the real issue here is the economic implications to earnings from the events in China and Hong Kong are far more significant than any other geopolitical events we've seen. The Arab Spring had minimal impact on U.S. corporate profits. Ukraine, minimal impact. This is a significant factor for U.S. corporate earnings for companies that do a lot of business, high tech, consumer companies. They're going to be affected if things turn worse. It's very good for U.S. real estate because we're seeing a flight of capital from China into high pockets of real estate in the U.S. and D.C. But at the same time, we look at emerging markets, we'll see that divergence. Pro-growth emerging markets like India are attracting a lot of capital this year and the stock market's doing well. Not pro-growth emerging markets, places like Brazil and China, will see a flight of capital as people fear what will happen to their assets where money's not going to be protected.